Joining an accelerator makes it so much easier to have access to people, to mentors who have experience in the field and who can actually add value to the process and point out things which will probably become issues for us sometime later. So discover them sooner than later, essentially. So I think in that sense, I'm very happy with all the people that we have got access to during the 100 days. Most founders don't understand that if in the first 6 months of their startup journey, if they were to join an accelerator, that they could benefit from it in various ways. And I think that is a huge challenge. If people opened up a little bit more to joining accelerators, they would really understand the true value that can be derived from it, maybe through networking, or even working in a space with other startups who are as enthusiastic in their journey as you are is very motivating.
On the first day, they asked, what is your wildest dream, right? So we said that we wanted to have around 20 to 30 paying customers, and I think we can't do that in another 2 months, but we're not sure we'll do it. But having now, I think next week we will actually have 15 to 20 customers, and we're really wondering whether our wildest dream have actually been met. But I feel that we should set a bigger number on our baseline session. Biggest thing is we had mentors, right? People who have already done this before. And that is one type of mentors. The other type of mentors were our immediate senior entrepreneurs, right? And Axelor as a community has such entrepreneurs. So they have actually gone through the same problems which we have gone just 6 months before. So interactions with them helped us actually speed in our progress. Another thing which we learned from Axelor is make sure that we ask ourselves the hard questions. See, always we know the hard question, but we don't really ask it to ourselves because we are not comfortable, right? And that is one culture which as a team we are building, right? Apart from us also, our team, they have the liberty of asking us the hard questions. And that's something which we learned from other entrepreneurs here, right? More than prayers, the process is more important.
When we came across Axelor and we came and spoke, and we liked, to be really honest, we liked the vibe that we were getting, and we felt like there was something here. So the way I look at it is that for most entrepreneurs, where the energy comes from is that they focus on things that they already like and are naturally good at. So what this does is it actually really amplifies the strengths, and that's of course important because that's what forms the personality of the entrepreneur as well as the personality of the startup itself. And without that, there wouldn't be any uniqueness in it. But what this also does is that the weaknesses sort of become blind spots, and it's not necessary that there are only weaknesses in an entrepreneur, but if there are 80 things that you're trying to pay attention to, the reality is you probably pay attention to 50 and you know that you're good at 20, but the accelerator program is about the other 30 points that you don't even know that you are missing out on. So I think it's very important for entrepreneurs to consider accelerators and incubators, and it's surprising because when you talk to most, everyone is worried constantly about, but it's not really funding, it's not really financially it won't make us more secure. The truth is that actually it will, because it will make your business better, it will make you understand your customer better, and it will make you pay attention to the things you don't even know that you're missing out on.
But coming down, being a part of Axelor in an accelerator program, it brought us discipline, it got us, we became accountable, we got introduced to mentors, people who we can work with, and all of them just coming together outside of an accelerator seems to be very difficult to happen.